Yeah, I mean, you know, after a rough, tough, 6 to 8 months, we needed that victory, and that gives us a lot of confidence, going forward. You know, as a young team, it was a great performance, especially after the first days of play. Thought we were disappointing with our bat in the first day, but credit should go to this young man here who batted brilliantly to get his, maiden Test century against a very strong Australian team. And Dhananjay De Silva contributed with his bat and ball. Chandimal, when needed, he got a few runs for us, and it was a collective effort by these batsmen. I mean, we had to rally around him. He was batting the best out of the lot, and we needed a 200-plus lead on that wicket. The wicket was assisting the spinners, and it was a great relief. Rangan Herath once again, proved his brilliance, and also Sandakan, coming into his first game, it was a brilliant effort by him. So it was, overall very pleasing effort, and we are humbled by the victory, but still a long way to go in the series.
Angelo, do you remember where you were in 1999 when Sri Lanka last won a Test match against Australia?
Well, I was, just told that. Well, about it, after 17 years, it's very pleasing to hear that, we've beaten Australia, and the credit should go to the whole team, the way they fought, the way they showed their character, well, against a very strong Australian team. Whether it's home or away, we had to play our best cricket to beat the Aussies, and we did. Especially after the first days of play, we had to come back really hard and strong, and we did that. So it was, yeah, it is very pleasing to hear that we won off. 16 years.
And just in terms of Rangana and Sandakan, do you think those guys, as two bowlers, are quite complementary? Like, they pose, ask different questions of the batsmen, which can make it, they're getting wickets for each other as well as for themselves.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, when Rangana is bowling, he's attacking, and also he contains. He holds one end together, and we needed someone like Sandakan, and Dilruan unfortunately didn't bowl that well in the game, but it was very pleasing to see Sandakan bowling his, googlies, and also the batsmen were finding it really tough to face him on this wicket.
Ajit, can you remember the last time when Sri Lanka beat Australia in 1999, and apparently for the next month, the Rangana made his debut in goal? Can you remember the last time when what were you doing?
Not really. I was I honestly can't remember. In 1999, I was just a little kid, but I'm sure that I watched bits and pieces, but I can't really remember the game. But Rangana, it's nice to hear that he played his debut after 1999, that victory, and also he's contributed towards this victory in a massive way.
Great. At 161, the scoreboard was not moving. There were 22 consecutive made no overs.
Yeah, it was. I mean, Steve O'Keefe and Peter Neville batted really well, and they made us work extremely hard for the wicket, and we had to just keep attacking and keep bowling and be patient. I mean, well, obviously we were a bit worried about the weather as well, but fortunately the weather gods didn't prevent us winning, and we just had to do our basics right. Rangana was bowling brilliantly right throughout the match, and Sandakan was bowling brilliantly. We were very hungry to take those couple of wickets, and we eventually did. I'm very pleased. Yeah, it is very important. I think this is a very good opportunity for us. I mean, and we'll try and enjoy the victory today, and get back to work, from next day. I mean, we have to. It's still a long way. As I said before, it's still a long way to go in the series. They will come back really hard, and we have to play our best cricket once again in Goa to try and seal the series. So we'll try and enjoy the series. And yeah, rankings. I'm not too worried about the rankings, as long as we do our processes right, and we go out there and do our very best and keep improving. I'm not really worried about the rankings.
Angelo, you sat here a few days ago being very low-key about your prospects, and now you're sitting here as the winning captain. How unexpected was that turnaround?
We knew, I mean, if we played to our potential, that we could beat the Australians. I mean, even though, it's very pleasing to be the number one team in the world, and and especially at home, I mean, it's not going to be easy. You know, as I said, the Aussies have performed extremely well in the recent past. They're in very good form. They've got some really good, good players. They've got a very good balance in the team. So, as I said, we had to play really good cricket, and it is very pleasing to beat the Australians in the very first game and, go into the second one.
From the first test against New Zealand and after the third test against England, and there were not many people were willing to put their money on Sri Lankans. But after this win, how are the feeling in the dressing room and how it looks like?
Yeah, the atmosphere in the dressing room has changed a lot. I mean, even though we lost in the past, in the recent past, we've not given up. We've always had hopes. We've always, helped each other. Every team goes through this transitional period, and once you click, you can go a long way. And that's what we believed in. That's why we kept, helping the players, helping the youngsters. Even the youngsters throw in their ideas, and it was a collective effort by the whole team.
Do you think the turnaround came with this young man?
Absolutely. I mean, the way he batted, especially playing his first test against Australia and a very strong bowling lineup. I mean, the way he batted, he showed a lot of class, a lot of temperament, and it was not easy to bat on that wicket. I mean, it was turning rapid, and their bowlers were bowling well and fast as well. And the way he looked, he made batting look so easy. And, most of us were struggling to get runs, and he made it so easy. And the way he batted, I'm very, excited for the future.